So with this attitude, is this, we may say that is opportunity to bring Christ to them. So the problem is our spirit. If you want to stay there as an antagonist, is if we stay there as a disciple of Christ is different. We need to take advantage of all the situations just to give Christ to other people. You are all very happy. Even in difficulties, in persecution, we are not now as our forefathers in the 18th, 19th century. Even in persecution, with many hardships, many difficulties, our forefathers, anxiousness, they were in peace because they were Christ. And thanks to that spirit, they transmit the gospel to other people, even to the communists. Just to say one example, about 2 weeks ago, a group of persons in a parish in Saigon, in Ho Chi Minh, city of Ho Chi Minh, came here to visit me. And at the end, they presented me a man. This man, 42 years, follow the Communist Party. Now, he follow Christ. And so he himself told me, I follow the party 42 years. Now I want to follow Christ. You see, we reflections of self, not the situation of other people outside. We ourselves. Every situation must be used as opportunity to make Christ known to the people.
Last question, Father.
I was wondering what I was listening to here. I was struck by what you said that one reason why we create religions is to get religious art. I saw a lot of people in the country. You see, it's because that how the religious was really done, not exposed by the if I release the information by the way I saw the way I see it, can I give most of the
the person to Christ. And this you can do only if you are familiar to Christ. Easy to teach doctrine. Much more difficult to introduce the person into the intimacy of Christ. With this, you cannot just lose the head. It is your life. And then the person is when he is open to Christ. Christ who does the rest, who do the rest. We are the bridge. We connect people to Christ. Even with our seminaries, with my seminaries in the circular, my fundamental thing is always this, to connect every seminarian to Christ, recalling them. Remember that the formation is the question, first of all, is their own passion to be Christ. The rector, the formators, help indicate the way. Remember, recall. But Christ is the one who transformed the heart through his spirit. So in all the catechesis, in all circumstances, the fundamental thing is to introduce the person, the group of the person, into the familiarity, into the intimacy of Christ. When you look at on the letters, and you see now the letters are light because they are connected to the source of the electricity. When the lamp is not connected to the electricity, it's dead. You can paint many colors, but that lamp cannot be light. The question is to connect the lamp with the source of the electricity. And all the rest, we give room for the Holy Spirit to Christ to do greatly. There is the great danger that we rely upon method. We rely on the actions of the people. On the method, the actions are good, necessary, but they are only instruments. But the problem will come when the church, we say church general, and the church put hope on these methods, on these actions, as if the success comes from them. And then whatever catechesis you can imagine, it just keeps failing. It's not life.
Thank you, Bishop Joseph, for the depth and clarity of your sharing, calling us to cultivate our desire for God, our relationship with Jesus as the starting point of our mission to do catechesis in our respective places of ministry. Bishop Joseph will be our main presider and homilist at the Mass in a few minutes. It is 5:30. Can we give each other 10 minutes to prepare? Kindly get your chasuble out and stole upstairs, and then proceed to the fourth floor chapel for our Vespers and our Eucharistic celebration. The following are the assistants to the bishops, Father Jerome, one of the Vietnamese priests, Father Robert Feliciano. First reading is Sister Sophie, prayers of the faithful is Father Ting. And of course, with Bishop Joseph, with the Archbishop Ramon, and Bishop Francis. For tomorrow, the assistant to the bishop, the assistants to the bishop are Father Jesus Manaay and Father Oselius Matale. First reading is Sister Maris and prayer of the faithful is Father Leo Garcia. This is for tomorrow. We will now proceed to the chapel. Let us give Bishop a good round of applause.
Gracias.